The international community also welcoming the grant of bail to former Senator De Lima. The European Union's envoy to Manila says this is a significant step in the Philippines' rule of law. It also calls for the swift resolution of De Lima's third drug case. Canada's embassy in Manila also welcoming the bail grant. Ottawa also says it expects her case to be concluded in full conformity with Philippine laws and with the country's international human rights obligations. The Dutch envoy to the Philippines, Marielle Heratz, recalls a past meeting with De Lima in hopes a former senator will soon achieve justice. As for Amnesty International, it calls the grant of bail a step towards justice for the former senator. They also call on the Marcos administration to ensure De Lima's safety as she regains temporary freedom. For Human Rights Watch Philippines, senior researcher Carlos Conde believes De Lima's temporary freedom has long been overdue. He says if the Muntinlupa court acquits De Lima of her third and final drug charge, it will be the first step towards repairing the Philippines' human rights reputation.
Certainly are very, very happy about the development. Of course, you wanted her to be acquitted and all that, but a bail at this point is long overdue. Obviously, the key thing to keep in mind here is the final decision by the Regional Trial Court of Muntinlupa to finally acquit her of these charges. There have been successive attractions of testimonies by several witnesses. There's really no reason for the court to just acquit her.
Let's get more details on the ruling of the Muntinlupa judge. We have on the line our correspondent, Mike Navalio. Go ahead, Mike.
Hi, Ron. We've just managed to read through the 69-page ruling of Muntinlupa Regional Trial Court, Branch 206 Judge Iner Gito, who ruled to grant the bail petition of former Senator Laila De Lima and several other co-accused. Essentially, Judge Gito was saying that the prosecution's nine witnesses were not able to clearly establish that there exists a conspiracy among them to commit illegal drug trading. He looked at the individual testimonies of these nine witnesses, and most of them, seven of them, were actually convicted witnesses. The most important witness, according to Judge Gito, Herbert Polanco, claimed that he was raising funds for the Lima senatorial bid. He claimed that he had given a total of about 45 million pesos. But when Judge Gito examined the testimony of Herbert Polanco, he concluded that the testimony was hearsay. The statement supposedly that they were to raise funds for the Lima senatorial bid actually came from J.B. Sebastian, a dead inmate, and not De Lima. And therefore, this would not establish the conspiracy to commit illegal drug trading. This was also true with respect to other convicted witnesses who also made the same allegation, supposedly to raise funds for De Lima's senatorial bid. One other witness was retired police superintendent or senior superintendent Jerry Valeroso, who claimed that he saw 65 million pesos worth of drug money inside the cubol of a Chinese inmate. But the court said even if this were true, this will not constitute direct or circumstantial evidence of common resolution to commit a crime. The Muntinlupa court also considered the testimony of retired General Benjamin Magalong, formerly head of the PNP-CIDG. But according to the court, this will not establish conspiracy as it only testified to the investigation conducted by the CIDG. On the contrary, the testimony of Magalong supposedly confirms that De Lima did not have any involvement in the illegal drug trading in the NBP. So the court as a whole said that the prosecution failed to present evidence to prove individual acts of accused that when combined would prove complicity. It was only supposedly J.B. Sebastian who was proven to have committed illegal drug trading, but the evidential link between him and De Lima and the other accused was not established. Now, the court said that assessing the totality of evidence presented by the prosecution, the court is of the firm view that accused De Lima, Bocayo, Dayan, Sanchez, and Dera should be allowed to post bail as prosecution was not able to discharge its burden of establishing that guilt of said accused is strong. Let's just put this into context, Ron. In cases which are supposedly non-bailable, like drug cases, like the one that former Senator De Lima is facing, the bail is not a matter of right. It is discretionary on the part of the judge. And you have to convince the judge that the evidence that the prosecution presented in court is not strong. And so it is this reason why the court took pains to point out that the evidence presented against De Lima and the other accused were not in fact strong. That's why he is now allowing them to post bail. So the next step to this, Ron, we understand that the prosecution has finished presenting evidence. They are just finalizing their formal offer of evidence. If that offer is accepted by the court, the camp of former Senator Laila De Lima and the other accused can move to dismiss the case on the basis of insufficiency of prosecution evidence in a process called demurrer to evidence. So that's what we are going to watch out for in the coming days, Ron. But for now, the team of former Senator Laila De Lima is currently processing her bail so that she could be out of the PNP Custodial Center at the end of the day today after more than 6 years and 8 months of detention. Ron?
Mike, thank you very much for the explanation and the update. Mike Navalio there. Former Philippine Senator Laila De Lima finally allowed to post bail in her last pending drug case. A Muntinlupa court granted De Lima bail of 300,000 pesos. She called the court's decision a moment of triumphant thanksgiving. De Lima thanked her legal team, supporters, and the Marcos administration for the development. The former lawmaker has been in detention since 2017 on drug-related charges that her camp has decried as political persecution.
For years, my whole being has been crying out for justice and freedom. For more than 6 long years, I've been praying so hard for this day to come. At alam niyo po, napakasakit. Ang pakulong
ka
na wala kang kasalanan. At ayaw ko pong mangyari to sa iba.
Her legal team says the court's decision reflects weak evidence from the prosecution's end. Attorney Bonita Cardon is optimistic they may soon see De Lima's last drug case junked.
Procedurally, ang prosecution ay nagsabit ng kanilang formal offer of evidence at sasagutin namin ito. At ng aming comment, binigyan kami ng 20 days from today. Ngayon, kung sakasakaling ma-resolve na yung formal offer of evidence, magapal din kami ng demurrer to evidence at hihilingin na namin ng tuluyang pagbusura ng kaso laban kay Senator Laila De Lima.